Normally, when we're trying to write the equation of a line in slope-intercept form, we would prefer to be given the slope, obviously, and the y-intercept. And if you have those two things, it's pretty clear of how we get the equation of the line. You just take those values and you plug them in the slope-intercept form of the line. But what will often happen is they might give you the slope of the line, but the point that it goes through won't be on the y-axis, but we'll still be asked to provide the slope-intercept form for the equation of the line. So let's see how we do that. So here it says, find the equation of the line with a slope of negative 2 that goes specifically through the point 1, 5. And so I can plot this. If the x is 1, when the y is 5, it would go through this point right here. Here's 1, 5. And then with the slope being negative 2, with the m being negative 2, or you could say negative 2 over 1, from this point that we know is on the line, we could go down 2 over 1 and down 2 over 1 and all those good things. And then we could get a graph for the equation of the line. So this is the line that has that particular slope that goes through that particular point. But what we're after is the slope-intercept form of the line y equals mx plus b. Now, part of this is pretty clear and pretty obvious. The m that was provided, which was negative 2, we can just take that and plug it in right now. So we'd have y equals negative 2x plus b, simply because m was negative 2. But here's where the tricky part happens. The b, unfortunately, is not 5, because 5 is not the y-intercept. It goes through 1, 5, not 0, 5. So here's the question. How do we determine the y-intercept just given some random point on the graph? Well, here's what we're going to do. Realize that the 1 is the x value and 5 is the y value. And with that being a point on the line, what that means is that ordered pair should make the equation be true. In other words, when you plug in 1 for x and 5 for y, you should have an equality here. So let's try that. We'll take the y out and substitute 5. At the same time, we'll take x out and substitute 1. And so in this updated equation, the only unknown now is the b. The b is the only thing we don't know. So negative 2 times 1 is negative 2. If we add that to the left-hand side, to the 5, we'll get 7. So b equals 7. So b equals 7. Okay, from here, we're pretty much done, because the m, as we said earlier, was negative 2, and the b is 7. So we can write our answer. Our answer is y equals mx plus b. In other words, we have negative 2x plus 7. So this is the equation of the line that has the correct slope and that goes through the specified point. If you want to double check real quick, just look at it. The m is negative 2. And try plugging in 1. Negative 2 times 1 is negative 2. Negative 2 plus 7 really does make 5. So anyways, that's how we find the equation of a line given a slope and some random point. Let's try one last one to finish up this video. Here it says, find the equation of the line with a slope of 3/4 that goes through the point 4, 2. So let me just get a rough sketch of this. Not that I need a rough sketch, but it would just help us think about this graph. So it has a point 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. So it goes through this point. And then you could either say that it goes up 3 and right 4, or you could say down 3, left 4, because 3 over 4, up 3, right 4, would be equivalent to negative 3 over negative 4. That's also 3/4, which means go down 3, back 4. And sometimes we'll do this because if we're already at a rightmost part of the graph, sometimes it's better to move left instead of move right. So that, I think that's what we'll do. We'll go down 1, 2, 3, and to the right 1, 2, 3, 4. And so we'll be right here. And then we can draw a line between those points. And it'll look something kind of like this, right? Something kind of like that. All right, so let's see if we can write the equation of this line then. So we'll start with y equals mx plus b. And we know the m, so I can go ahead and plug in 3/4 for m. But again, I don't know the b, I don't know the y-intercept, because that's not the point I was provided. I was provided the point 4, 2. So what this means is I can take 4 for x and take 2 for y and substitute them in the equation, and it should make the equation be true. Let's try it. So we'll take 2 and plug it in for y. We'll take 3/4 times 4 plus b. So we'll let x be 4. And then we'll solve for b. Notice here the 4 divided by 4 cancels, and we'll be left with a 3. So 2 equals 3 plus b. And of course, that makes the b be negative 1. All right, so I've got my slope of 3/4. I've got my y-intercept of negative 1. And I can actually see that kind of. Look over here on the graph. Doesn't it look like it crosses the y-axis at negative 1? I think it does. So our final answer will be y equals mx plus b. In other words, 3/4 x minus 1. So again, this is how we find the equation of a line in slope-intercept form given the slope of the line and just some random point that the line goes through.